Curry Maffitt Insurance has been a part of our community for the past 117 years. Come in today at our brand new location in downtown Dublin and experience the difference an independent agent can make. At Curry Maffitt Insurance, we can handle all your insurance needs, including home, auto, and business. Plus, we're local. Since 1902, Curry Maffitt Insurance, now at 115 West Jackson Street in downtown Dublin.
It's Renee with CSB for you and me, and I'm here today to talk about HR. HR, what does HR stand for? Oh my gosh, if you've ever had a job, you know what HR is all about. Human resources. This is Terry Richards. She is our soon-to-be sliding in CFO, right, Terry?
That is correct.
And where are you from? Are you from around here?
I am. I was actually born and raised in Dublin, Georgia. I lived in Jacksonville for almost 20 years and have now come back to
CSB
for you and me.
Yeah. So tell me a little bit about what your role is with HR for CSB.
Well, with the HR side, I oversee the HR operations of CSB for the 16 county area, just to be sure we're getting the right talent, looking for the right folks, and making sure we have our operations on the HR side in order.
Tell me a little bit about how we have our hiring process work. If I wanted a job, is it in the newspaper?
Yes. Well, your hiring manager first would contact HR to determine what the needs are, and then we would put together a job posting, and that goes out to several different places, some of the job boards like Indeed, LinkedIn, and then on the state boards, may go in the newspaper, depends on the critical need of the particular position, because sometimes they're harder to fill in certain areas.
Right.
So we could put them in professional organizations. If there's a nursing, say a nursing need, we might put one of those in one of the trade magazines.
And being in a rural area, I know that's got to be a struggle.
Yes,
it's interesting to know that if there's a specific job that you need in this direction, then we are looking to find things in that realm or in that world to say, hey, we need somebody to work for us in nursing. So I've even just instantly thought, I've gone to tech schools and spoke to the students, and so there are opportunities through your schooling even to find jobs with us.
Yes, we do do job fairs and things like that at the schools, at some of the local colleges and the technical colleges, and we also have intern positions. So we have interns who come in throughout the year, and actually we have several who return to us after their internships are over and look for a job.
So if you're interested, if you're in school and you need an internship, you can call us up at CSB of Middle Georgia, and you can talk to our HR department and see if you might be interested in an internship. So they contact the HR department for internships.
Right.
I think that was an interesting thing, because when I was growing up and going through school, I was like, I don't really know where to start with my internship or how to contact them. So today I've learned something, even though I'm through with school. If you're interested in internships, then you can come. Just call the HR department of any program. But behavioral health is always a fun field to get in, so think about it.
For sure.
Let's talk about the different varieties of jobs. We've got stuff for doctors and nurses, but we also have stuff for drivers, van drivers. We've also got stuff for secretaries.
We do. We have anything from administrative positions. We have HR, accounting positions. We have administrative assistant positions. We have doctors, nurses, licensed counselors, community workers. We even have client support workers who go out and help our clients. We have positions I probably don't even know yet, because I am fairly new.
Right.
We still have lots of positions that I'm not sure what the acronyms are for yet. It is such a unique world. I did not come from the healthcare CSB world. I came from for-profit manufacturing, so it's been quite an experience to learn all of the new positions, but incredibly touching to learn these positions. I was actually semi-retired and came back to the working world because of CSB. If it had been another position with another organization, I would not have I would not have given up my retirement for that.
Right. I try to explain to people that we try to help people. Everyone who works with us and in our programs has a heart to help people. And then I naturally blend into its mission. It's a mission field. So I'm thankful that you bring that point up, that what we do is a beautiful thing, and it's exciting to come to work because we help people. And sometimes it's temporary help, sometimes it's help forever, but I bet, I've never thought about it from an HR point of view. Welcome to our program, welcome to our family of work, and welcome to our mission field.
Right, because
join the team.
We want to be an employer of choice.
Right.
We want the people to want to come to work with us. And we feel that we're doing a really good job with that and showing them the programs. We're actually developing a brand new program right now called Live, Learn, Lead. Thank you, Renee, for that name.
Live, Learn, Lead.
Yeah. It will be a leadership development program that will be an internal program.
Yes.
We're kicking this off for next year, so it will help us develop our pipeline of talent to move into the leadership roles as people do retire. So that's exciting for us to get to do that.
Yes. I'm very excited about that, and I'm glad you mentioned it, because for those who are not totally following what we're talking about, we are going to grow our employees. So people who come in and have a job, if they have the desire to be more than they are, then we're going to help mold them, help educate them, help give them the leadership skills that they need, all because of Miss Terry Richards coming in and helping us with our leadership
development program.
Leadership development program. So if you work for us and you're watching this, There is a process. You've probably already heard Ms. Terry talk about what the process and steps are going to be. With you talk to your supervisor, get your paperwork together. You have to apply or submit that you're interested to participate.
Yeah, we'll be putting out marketing materials for this over the next few weeks, so you'll see something coming out on that. But any agency, any organization is only as good as the people who work for it.
Amen.
Yep.
So, I really believe that.
Oh, absolutely.
Even as a supervisor, you're only as successful as the people
who work for you. And that's something that we really are trying to stress to our managers right now, is preparing those people coming up behind them how to step into that next level role.
Yay, I'm so glad you work for us now.
Me too.
Is going to be fun. So I hope, and I've been hoping that I get to help with this.
Yes.
With Terry, so I get to mingle more with our staff within all 16 counties. I think our viewers might forget that and think that we're just Dublin based, but we are 16 counties through the state. So hopefully you're seeing on your screen right now the 16 counties that we serve. So if you live within these 16 counties, or you know family members that do, that might be looking for a job, that might want to grow within the behavioral health world of work, you can just give us a call. You can look on LinkedIn, on Indeed.com, in the newspaper. There's just different ways that we advertise job positions.
And you can drop by our account, our HR offices and pick up an application, because we do accept those on site. And it is very difficult to recruit in some of the more rural areas. So if you have an interest in this line of this field, if you've got a helping field degree, we are always looking.
We can put you to work. We are a larger agency than people think, not just our 16 counties, but our head count of employees. I think I heard Denise say around 600.
We've got approximately 600 people spread out throughout the 16 county area.
So to me, that also gives me confidence and encouragement that this is a stable program, a stable company to work for. A lot of people who've worked here have worked here for 20, 30 years. So that's a plus when you're looking for a job, is to know that it's a stable, steady company.
That's exactly one of the reasons that I decided to come back to work as I met with the senior leadership team and we discussed this position, is everybody around the table had been here for 20 plus years, and the people that I know in this agency that have been here for so many years, you can't work anywhere unless it's somewhere you want to be
right.
for that many years.
Right.
And they still love what they do, and they don't want to leave.
Right. Well, we'll be back after these messages to talk to you more about HR with CSB for you and me.
Have you been thinking about buying or selling a home, but you don't really know where to start? Well, my name is Duana Cooper, and I work for Coldwell Banker Curry Residential, and I could make your real estate transaction easy, pain-free, and even a little bit of fun. When you use a real estate agent in your transaction, you have someone that works for you, someone that's in your corner, someone that can help you negotiate, get through all the pages of that contract, as well as make sure that the transaction runs smoothly from start to finish. I'm honest and candid, and I pride myself on being friendly and approachable. Earlier this year, I was fortunate enough to sell this home on Orchard Lake Road, but I also sell investment property and commercial property. So if you have a need, please reach out to me. We'll get the job done and have a little fun. I'm Duana Cooper, and I work for Coldwell Banker Curry Residential.
Hey everybody, we're back with CSB for you and me, and we're here today talking with Terry Richards about our HR program at CSB of Middle Georgia. And while we were at break, we thought about the idea of explaining again what behavioral health services are and what all the different categories that go under that, because it is, again, an overwhelming, large coverage area, not just our 16 counties that we serve, but behavioral health can mean mental health services. So within our mental health, Terry, we can have counselors, LPNs.
The RNs, we have the crisis unit, we have...
That's another episode, our crisis unit. We hadn't got to that yet.
Right,
but
yeah,
so
the physicians, we have community support workers who actually go out into the community and go into homes.
Yeah.
So if that's something that's an interest to you, we do have that.
I'm really jumping, but we have a residential program where you help check on individuals within their homes, make sure their food's cooked, their dishes are clean, they're taking their medicine right. CSI workers or community individuals go in to check on, is the home safe? Mm-hmm. Is the home fun? Is it clean? Mm-hmm. Caseworkers, that's within the mental health realm. Mm-hmm. That's helping to make sure, are you getting your social security check? Are you getting your, all your paperwork in order for insurance?
Right, and those individuals who work with that actually do help those people get their bills paid, they
right.
do all these things for them and make sure that those things are being taken care of.
Right, so if you're good at budgeting and money mm-hmm. and paperwork, you might be interested in working within our mental health clinics. So then we have our substance abuse, so that's a little bit of rise up.
Mm-hmm.
You got to learn how to do that,
rise up.
He does
Cameraman.
It best.
Oh, okay. And then step one, which is a recovery-based program also.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe you have experience with substance abuse and you are in recovery.
We have our peer support specialists who receive a good bit of training to be able to do that. And they've got lived experience.
Mm-hmm.
So they are the best people to help people through recovery
mm-hmm.
because they've been there themselves. And that's a big help.
And we need those. So maybe you're saying to yourself, I don't have the education, I don't have the books edge smart, but maybe you have lived experience with substance abuse or even mental health
mm-hmm.
challenges, but you have overcome your challenges and you're in recovery. This, you could work for us because we need you to say, hey man, I've been there, I've done that, I can help you, look how far I've come, you can do that too. So sometimes some of the positions are not as strong on educational background.
Exactly. Some of the higher level positions, of course, have to have bachelor's degrees, but we do look at that experience because
mm-hmm.
that is just as important in most situations as some of the education.
Mm-hmm.
Education can't teach you what you can learn from an experience.
And I think people out there who are like, man, I just don't have the education, but I have the experience. I wish there was something out there. You just heard it. So if you want a job and you have experience, don't let the education stuff stop you. Try, apply.
And we do lots of training. We spend a lot of time. We have people in our HR department that actually focus strictly on the training aspect and making sure that we receive, because we are heavily trained in most aspects. So we have a lot of training that's scheduled. We have in-house training. We have external training that is required every year.
Yeah. I'm fixing to go, and this is a totally different episode too. CSB is, and Voices of Hope is sponsoring me to go learn to be the trainer for QPR, for Question, Persuade, and Refer, to help people with suicide prevention. That is something I wouldn't have if I didn't work for CSB in Middle Georgia.
Exactly.
So I'm going to go to that training and be able to bring that back to the table. Mm-hmm. Certified Peer Specialist, CSB in Middle Georgia will help you get registered, signed up, apply for the training, pay for it for you to go, so you can bring that back to the table and be a successful employee for us. So let's talk about CNA, maybe some of the jobs that might be open for our children and adolescents.
Oh, that's always an exciting area, as I'm sure most of the people who have been following this already know, because CNA is wonderful. But the clubhouse, I just toured the clubhouse a week or so ago. That is amazing, and the opportunities there with the little lunch area, the place for food, the emerging adults, the den,
right,
and the people that work in there. There's areas for playtime, for movie time, for dance, for everything, and they have to have people in all of those programs to help with those.
So if you have experience with child care, you might be interested in working at the SOAR Clubhouse. And maybe you have lived experiences. Mm-hmm. Just to kind of connect, of what we're saying is, maybe you grew up in a dangerous or a bad environment as a child, so you have lived experience with how children may live or may be struggling today, because you've been there, you've done that. So you could qualify to work with us to help these children have a better life.
Yeah.
So
don't assume just because you may not have a degree that it rules you out. Be sure to, if there's something that you're interested in, be sure to contact us and to let us look at that, any opportunities.
Follow your dreams, follow your hearts. If you need a job and this sounds like something that's interesting, then give us a call. It's not going to hurt to try.
That's right.
See how easy it is to talk to her? It's not a big deal. You just call and ask for the HR department.
That's right.
Is there anything specific that you want the viewers to know, that you want the community to know, when it comes to applying for a job or how our system may work as a CSB?
Okay, I have to put on my HR hat now.
Okay.
This is not necessarily for CSB.
Uh-huh.
I do a lot of interview training. I've done that in a consulting job that I've had before. So when you go for an interview, always put your best foot forward. Make sure you're dressed appropriately. Think about all those things that go into an interview and what you would like to see if you had someone interviewing with you for a job. So that's not a CSB thing. That's just an HR. HR thing. So, take your rollers out of your hair.
I always think, wear closed-toe shoes.
Right, right.
Wear a dress if you're a woman. Wear a coat if you're a man.
Yeah, just appropriate.
Look your best, basically. Mm-hmm. You're selling yourself, basically.
That's right.
Is an easy way to say it. But
And we're peculiar about who takes care of the people we serve.
Yeah.
So we want to be sure we're hiring the best for those.
All right. Well, I appreciate your time today.
Thank you.
I think this is a very neat idea of a episode. Sometimes we just think we do this, but there's a lot of behind the scenes of making sure that the people who are doing this and this and this are qualified to do it, or have the lived experience to do it. So I'm very thankful, and I hope our viewers have learned something today. And come get a job, look for a job. There's 16 counties. So if you live in Montgomery County, there's a job in Montgomery County that we can help you if you're interested. If you live in Swainsboro, there's a job in Swainsboro. You'll see our 16 counties again. We are a large coverage area, and so I want to make sure that you know that this is our Dublin show through our Dublin TV channel, but that doesn't necessarily mean that all of our positions are in Dublin.
Exactly. Anywhere in the 16-county catchment area, and even in Hepzibah.
And even in Hepzibah, which is not, but we do have some.
We do have.
We have a home there. Mm-hmm. So, residential, maybe you like night work. Maybe you like that Monday through Friday work. We've got day programs. Maybe you're not substance abuse. Maybe you're development disabilities. We haven't talked about that. We can't go yet. We can't go yet. We have got a whole nother part that we have not discussed. So those with development disabilities, we have day programs for them. Mm-hmm. Oh, gosh. We have a bunch of them. And it's not just in Dublin. There's one in Pulaski.
Right. I can't remember all of them.
I can't either. And I just started trying to name them. Pulaski, Montgomery County. Oh, we've got a couple in Lawrence County. We've got them in Emanuel County. We've got them in Screven County. We've got them in Burke County and Jenkins County. See, we're that big. So maybe you have an adult. You might not know all this yet. But maybe if you have an adult or someone in your family that is almost an adult, that has a development disability that's something similar to autism or Down syndrome, just a lower IQ, there are day programs Monday through Friday that we need staff to help with and work with, building life skills with those individuals and having just peer support for them. So,
yeah, building the life skills is very important because these are people who live in the communities and many are very high functioning and are able to live out on their own. They just need the little extra help, teaching them how to manage money, how to maybe make a meal for themselves, and the day programs help with that.
So if you have a heart for that or a passion for working with individuals in that circumstance, then we have the job for you within the counties, hopefully, that you do live in. So we've got multiple day programs for individuals with development disabilities also, which, gosh, I keep thinking of more and more. That's how big we are. I keep thinking of more and more stuff. But we have residential programs, too, for our development disabilities. So maybe there's someone who is extremely autistic and doesn't have the support and love of a family to take care of them. They can live independently, and we need staff to help check on them within their home and programs and make sure they stay active within the community. So there's a lot of work that we can do. I'm telling you about the programs, but think about the staff, the people that we need.
Yes, exactly. And this is not just a job. These are people's lives. Mm-hmm. So everyone you help, it's someone's life, and that's why it's so important. It's not just, you're not making a widget. You're not coming in here to make a widget that's going to be shipped out to somebody. It's actually you're impacting someone's life.
Yeah, it's kind of fun. We're blessed. There's my word for this episode. Yes. We're blessed. I say blessed every episode. Every episode, we're blessed.
We are.
And it's a mission. You'll learn quickly if you have a heart for this work. And then if you do, you become family. So. I keep trying to close the show, but I keep thinking of other stuff too. So let's just take a break, and we'll be back in just a minute to wrap up our episode on HR for CSB for you and me.
With Georgia Farm Bureau Insurance, I can get auto, home, life, even banking all in one place. Pretty convenient if you ask me.
Always the home team, Georgia Farm Bureau Insurance. Visit us online at gfbinsurance.com.
Hey everybody, we're back for the final segment of CSB for you and me discussing HR, our human resources. So before we leave, I want to make sure that you're aware that you need to call this number, the 1190 number, and ask for HR. And then when you ask for HR, the process, real quick, what's the process that we go through if someone's interested in a job?
Right. So you'd want to fill out an application, probably submit a resume. Once you're called and interviewed, then there is a background screening process. So we do background checks, fingerprint checks, drug screens. Once you've passed all of those items, then you actually come in to meet with hiring managers. So it's a little bit of a process, but so is everything. But like I said, we want to be sure we're hiring the right people to take care of the people we serve. So we have to do those checks to make sure we're not putting anyone in danger.
Right.
So we have to have those completed. And then once the hiring managers sign off, then we make an offer.
So you've heard it. You know what to do. You can't say you don't. You come see us, call this number, the 1190, ask for HR. Just keep stepping through the processes that they tell you, okay, now we've done this, now you need to do this. Just keep going through those so you can get your interview and you can be part of our CSB family. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned a lot today, and I'm so excited that maybe I could be your coworker. This is Renee with CSB for you and me.